You probably eat three meals a day. Modern life is designed around this concept of eating. We're told breakfast is the most important meal of the day, we're given lunch breaks at work, and our social lives revolve around evening meals. But is this the healthiest way to eat? The concept of intermittent fasting is becoming increasingly popular, with its health benefits proposed from research trials. In this video, I'll be exploring the effects of fasting on your body. I'm Hafiz and I'm a cardiologist training in London. If you're new to the channel, here I educate on heart health and topics relating to cardiology. If you haven't already, please subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss the next video. The concept of breakfast is relatively new and came about during the Industrial Revolution in the 19th century and the introduction of working hours. Over the centuries, we've become conditioned to three meals a day, but this is being challenged now as people's attitude to food is changing. When we came off rations, we embraced three meals a day because there was suddenly an abundance of food. Today, we have more sedate lifestyles. We're not doing the level of work we were doing in the 19th century, so we actually need fewer calories. Even more so now, when the morning commute is the thing of the past for some people, as working from home is becoming the new norm. So, what is the concept of intermittent fasting? Intermittent fasting is when you restrict your food intake to an 8-hour window, so you'd be fasting the rest of the 16 hours in the day. You would also not be snacking in between meals, but you are allowed to drink water. So what's the science behind the health benefits? When you eat a normal meal, glucose from carbohydrates and fatty acids from fats are the main sources of energy for your cells. After you've eaten, glucose is used as a direct source of energy, and fatty acids are stored as fat in the form of triglycerides. When you fast, the cells in your body go into a self-protection mode because they are suddenly under stress, as there is no food. Your body runs out of glucose and needs another source of energy to keep going. So the body uses fat for fuel. As a result, you lose weight. And weight loss improves blood pressure and reduces your risk of getting cardiovascular disease, such as a heart attack and a stroke. Fasting also affects two key hormones in the body. The first is insulin. When you fast, you decrease insulin production and also improve insulin sensitivity. Insulin is an important hormone as it helps to regulate the sugar levels in your body. So when you fast, you decrease your risk of diabetes, and we know that diabetes is a big risk factor for cardiovascular disease. Too much insulin for too long can also increase inflammation, result in higher blood pressure, and oxidative stress. So when you fast, you decrease insulin production and reduce the inflammatory process in your body. The other hormone that is affected by fasting is growth hormone. Fasting causes an increase in growth hormone. Growth hormone helps to preserve proteins that help you look younger. It's involved in bone density and collagen production. It's also one of the main fat-burning hormones, and it preserves muscle mass. As you age, growth hormone levels in your body decrease. Growth hormone increases with exercise and with fasting. And it's of course Ramadan at the moment. Ramadan is observed by Muslims around the world, and it involves 1 month of fasting from sunrise to sunset. This is a dry fast, so you're not drinking water either during the periods of fasting. In theory, it's adding more stress to the body, so all the effects I spoke about could be amplified. So is fasting for everyone? First and foremost, everybody is different and we live different lives. I think there is certainly a caution in particular cases, for example, if you have poorly controlled diabetes. I would speak to your GP. or your diabetes nurse or doctor on the best approach. If you are otherwise generally in good health and interested in exploring intermittent fasting, I'd suggest you ease yourself into it and maybe try it out for a day and see if it suits your lifestyle. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.